Welcome to part 2 of probability. In part 1, we had learnt about random experiments and then about probability. Probability is the certainty of occurring of any event. The certainty, that means if I am tossing a coin, I get two outcomes, either a head or a tail. And that is certain. To get either a head or a tail, that's a certain event. So that's called probability. So in this case, when we see, we had seen some examples also last time, we are doing some new examples. A bag contains 5 red, 7 blue and 2 green balls. And a ball is selected at random, because this is a random experiment. Any ball can be selected and all the balls have equal chances of getting selected. Find the probability of selecting a red ball, a green and not a blue ball. So first of all, we have to see how many total balls are there. 5 plus 7 plus 2. That means there are 14 balls. Out of 14 balls, what is the probability of selecting the red ball? Once again, I say that the probability of selecting any ball is equal. They have equal probabilities of getting selected. So what we do, we write the total number of balls, that is the total outcomes in the denominator. 7 plus 5 plus 2 is 14. And out of that, if I have to select a red ball, how many red balls have been given? 5. That means the probability of selecting a red ball from this bag is 5 by 14. That 14 means the total number of outcomes, that is the total number of balls. Here it comes in the denominator, and the favorable outcome, that is red, that comes in the numerator. Here if I see a green ball, once again this will remain as 14 because the total number of balls is 14. But the green balls, I have only 2 green balls with me. 2 green balls, that means 2 will be coming in the numerator. It can be reduced to lowest term as 1 by 7. So this is the probability of getting a green ball. The third part is not a blue ball. That means it can be either a red or a green ball. Not a blue ball means either a red or a green. So what is the probability of a red ball? It's, we have found out, 5 by 14. And what is the probability of a green ball? It's 2 by 14. We have found out from here, 2 by 14 and 5 by 14 from this step. Because it's not a blue ball, that means it is either red or either green. So these two probabilities are added up and we get 7 by 14, or in lowest term as 1 by 2, as 7 cancels out with 14 as 1 by 2. So this is how we find out probability when the total number of outcomes is given and the favorable outcome we have to see, and then put it in the numerator, divide by the total number of outcomes, and this is how we get probability. We'll do one more example. We see this example. Out of 200 scholars at a conference, 80 were scholars in English, 50 in science and the rest in astronomy. If a person is selected at random, find the probability of selecting a science scholar, not an astronomy scholar, either an English or a science scholar. That means there were 200 people in all at a conference, out of which 80 were English scholars. So first of all, I have to write the total number of outcomes. Here it is 200. The total number of guests is 200. So that comes in the denominator. And out of this, if I have to select a science scholar, how many science scholars have been given? 50. That means the favorable outcome is 50. Once again, the total number of guests is 200. That the total number of scholars is 200. And the favorable thing is 50. And now I reduce it to lowest term as 1 by 4. Because 50 and 200 cancel out as 1 by 4. 50 into 4 is 200. Next, not an astronomy scholar. That means if he is not an astronomy scholar, he must be either an English scholar or a science scholar. That means rest, suppose first of all 80 were English, 50 were in science. That means 80 plus 50 is 130 already. That means that astronomy scholars can be subtracted from 200 minus 130 will give me 70. So 70 scholars will be there for astronomy, as 80 plus 50 is 130 and the total number of scholars are 200. 200 minus 130 gives me 70. That means I have only 70 astronomy scholars. But here I have to see that he should not be an astronomy scholar. So either I find out the probability of an astronomy scholar by 70 by 200 and subtract it from 1. Or else what I do is I add up these two, 50 and 80, and then write here as 130 by 200 because these are not astronomy scholars. These are science and English scholars. So I add them up and I get 130 by 200. Again, this 0 cancels out and the lowest term is 13 by 20. So this is the way we can do it. Or else we could have done it 70 by 200. I could have got the number of astronomy scholars. The probability of astronomy scholars will be 70 by 200. And then I subtract it from 1. Here, either an English or science. That means either he has to be an English scholar or a science scholar. So once again, 50 science and 80 in English. So that means we add up these two, 80 plus 50. As the denominator is common, so we can directly add them up. We get again 130 by 200. And in lowest terms, we get 13 by 20 as the required probability. See this, that this and this is equal. Why equal? Because it's an either English or a science scholar. And here also we were saying that he should not be an astronomy scholar. That means he is bound to be either an English scholar or a science scholar. In this example, we see that in a survey of 100 households with 2 children, that means every household had only 2 children, they were only selected for the survey. 35 families had 1 son. 1 son means 1 son and 1 daughter. That means 35 families had 1 son and 1 daughter. 45 had 2 daughters and the rest had 2 sons. That means 35 plus 45, it gives me 80. And that means out of 180 had these kind of things like 1 son and 1 daughter or 2 daughters. That means the rest means that 20 households had 2 sons. 20 households had 2 sons. A family selected at random, find the probability that this family, it's a family with exactly 1 girl child. That means there has to be only 1 girl child, not 2. So here the total number of outcomes is 100, as 100 has been the survey, because 100 households has been the survey. So this is the 100. Outcome will be, number, total number of outcomes will be 100. And 1 girl child, in how many families are we finding only 1 girl child? See here, 20 families have 2 sons. I write 20 here because we have calculated. 20 have 2 sons, 45 have 2 daughters. And here in 35 families, there is 1 son and 1 daughter. That means it will be 35 here. Because we want only 1 daughter, exactly 1 girl child. So here we get it, when we just do the lowest term, it is going with 5, 5 sons are 7 by 20. So this is how we get the probability of getting a girl, a household with exactly 1 girl child. Next, at least 1 boy child. That means either 1 boy or 2 boys in the family, or 1 minus 0 boy in the family. So that means 1 boy, what is the probability of having 1 boy? 35, because they had 1 son. And 45 had 2 daughters, so there is no scope of a boy child. And the rest 20 families had 2 sons. That means we can add up 35 and 20. 55. We get 55 by 100 here. And it is, again we cancel it out, 11 by 20. Then we come to the third one. Both are either boys or both are girls. That means 2 daughters or 2 sons in the family. 45 had 2 daughters and 20 had 2 sons. So we add up these two. 45 plus 20 upon 100, because 100 is the total number of outcomes. It will remain the same every time. It is 65 by 100. You can directly write it as 0.65. Or else you can just make it a fraction. You cut it with 5, 5 ones are 5, 3 and then 20. 13 by 20 is the probability, or else 0.65 is the probability that the family selected at random has either boys or both are girls. Both are either boys or both are girls. That means 45 had 2 daughters, 20 had 2 sons. We add them up, 65 by 100, 0.65 or 13 by 20. In this example, we see that there was a survey conducted for an airline to find out how many times it got delayed or cancelled or reached on time. So here in a survey of airlines, it was found that flights of airlines A got delayed 90 times out of 300. That means the total number of outcomes was 300 and reached on time 180 times and reached before 20 times. That means before time it reached 20 times, on time 180 and 90 times it got delayed. And the rest of the times it got cancelled. Rest means I have to serve 300 is the total. I have to subtract 180 plus 90 plus 20 from this. 180 plus 90 plus 20, that means it comes out to be 290, and I have to subtract from 300. So 10 number of times it got cancelled. 10 number of times it got cancelled. So I have to find the probability that the flight got cancelled. How many times it is getting cancelled? 10 times. And the total number of outcomes is 300. So it means 10 by 300 or 1 by 30. So this is the probability that the flight selected at random may get cancelled. It's 1 by 30. How I have reached to this 10? Because 90 times it got delayed, 180 times it is reaching on time, and 20 times before time. So that means only 10 times it is getting cancelled. Because 300 minus 90 minus 180 minus 20 gives me 10. So this is how we calculate the probability of a flight getting cancelled. So now I have to find out the probability of a flight reaching on time. That means 180 times it is reaching on time. So 180 by 300. 180 by 300 is my required probability, but because it is not in lowest term, I cancel it out with 6. 6 3s are 6 5s are. 6 5s are 30, 6 3s are 18. So it is 3 by 5 is my final probability that is required. Now we have to find out the probability that the flight doesn't reach on time. It can mean 3 things. Like it is getting cancelled altogether, it is getting delayed, or it reaches before time. All 3 things can come here because it is not reaching on time. So on time is only 180 times. If I add up all the other things, 90 is the delay, 10 is the cancellation, and 20 times it is reaching before time. So that means it's not reaching on time, but rather we should not include before time. But here, as the question says, doesn't reach on time. Suppose the flight is supposed to reach at 10:05 and it is reaching at 9:50. So that means it is not reaching on time, it is before time. So we add up all these 3, that is 180, and 180 is on time. Leave this 90 plus 10 is 100, and then 20 which is reaching before time. So it will be 120 upon 300. You can check it also, because here it was reaching on time is 180 times. So 1 minus 180 by 300 will also give me the time when it is not reaching on time. So here we cancel it out with 3 also, it will go 4 and 10. See, this is going with 3, 3 4s are, 3 10s are, again it will be 2 by 5. One more direct method is that 1 minus 3 by 5, because when the flight is reaching on time, probability is 3 by 5. So 1 minus 3 by 5 is also going to give me 2 by 5, which is the probability that the flight is not reaching on time. Whether before time, whether cancelled, or whether getting delayed, it's all the same. In coming parts also, we'll be dealing with more and more problems of probability, like tossing up of 2 coins, tossing up of 2 dice, 1 coin and 1 die together. So these are the kinds of problems we'll be dealing in coming lectures. Hope you're liking all our videos. So send in your queries and suggestions in the comment box. Share the videos with your friends and watch out for the latest videos. Press the bell icon. Subscribe to Ideainfini.